In Ethiopia, where I come from, the state controls every little detail of people's lives. They have a physical surveillance and an online surveillance.
It's a very difficult society to live in. The default setting is repression. The government controls the internet to control journalism. When you control the narrative, you control the power.
But through technology, I believe my people can take that freedom back. My name is Endalk Chala. I'm a doctoral student in communication studies. But before I came here from Ethiopia, I was an activist. I'm still an activist.
Before I start the class, I just want to talk a little bit about privacy. Anyone has a right to privacy.
Privacy is a human right. So for me, privacy is just to be left alone. But privacy is some kind of alien concept in Ethiopia. The problem is repression.
Ethiopia has essentially been under one-party government for more than 20 years now. Political opposition members are being jailed and tortured. Journalists are getting arrested, charged with terrorism, put in jail for many years.
In Ethiopia, the main prison is divided into different zones, from zone 1 to zone 8. It's kind of dark, but they call all of Ethiopia zone 9 because we're all part of the prison.
I consider myself as a journalist who has been writing on different social issues and political issues in Ethiopia.
This photo is the entire member of blogging collective called Zone 9.
Because we have used internet to tell story which offended the government, my friend is Zone 9 bloggers apprehended and thrown into prison.
Three of us escaped prison.
The first thing for Ethiopian journalists to know of the Ethiopian environment is it's a controlled one, which is highly spied by the government. You need to protect yourself. How? By using encryption.
These days, journalists need to code and coders need to be journalists. The lines between the two are blurring. I'm still in touch with activists who do not use secure technology and they're risking their lives. What I do is send them
a collection of tools, tips, and technologies which will help both regular people and journalists to protect themselves.
Yo, Jitsi, and then Mr. explain that.
Technology has helped them to speak their stories and to do journalism. That makes technology a very good thing. Technology gives voice for the voiceless. It gives opportunity for deprived people to tell their story. Ethiopia is my country, I love my country. But I need to participate in helping people to protect themselves.
Privacy is important because there has to be an interior zone within each person that government doesn't see or control. This zone is for ideas and thoughts and free expression. A zone where you can share your doubts, secrets and weakness. If Ethiopians had this, we could take down all 9 zones. Through technology, we can build a brighter future for Ethiopia. And that's what I'm fighting for.